Hello friends, welcome to Tech With Us and in the video tutorial series on CAN protocol. Friends, till now in the part 1 and part 2 of this series, we have built up a good understanding about CAN protocol. We had highlighted there its feature and tried to understand what was the need to introduce such a protocol. And then we have also looked its various standards. So in this video, we will do a quick recap. But if you have not watched the previous videos, please watch them first. The link of this series is available in the description box. Then later in this video, I am going to introduce various CAN frame formats. So let's start. In part 1, we started by highlighting few important features of CAN protocol. Like CAN is not a master-slave type of communication, where only master can initiate the communication. In CAN network, there is no need of a host or master node. Then CAN bus is a broadcast type of bus, means activities on the bus is monitored by all the node connected in the network. For example, it's not possible for node A to send a particular message only to node B. Eventually, all the other nodes will get this message, and if it is not relevant to them, they might discard it. This makes CAN a message-based protocol, means each message in the CAN network is labeled with a message identifier. We will talk about this more in this video. In part 2, we had discussed about the OSI reference model. According to this model, the CAN architecture defines two layers, data link layer and physical layer. Then we had discussed CAN standard, which are defined under ISO 11898 family. ISO 11898 has three parts. Part 1, which covers the specification for data link layer, and part 2 and 3 covers the CAN physical layer for high speed and low speed CAN respectively. The latest version of CAN specification is CAN 2.0, which has two parts. Part A, which defines the standard frame format with an 11-bit identifier, and Part B defines the extended frame format with an 29-bit identifier. Great, so let's start looking at the CAN frame structure from a very general perspective. We will talk about the frame types later, but first we need to understand various elements of the frame. The first element is the arbitration field, which is also called as message identifier. Then we have control field, which defines the user-defined functions. Then we got the data field, where the actual data can be kept. Following to this, we have CRC and acknowledgement field. Apart from this, each CAN message must start with a start of frame bit and ends with end of frame bits. Start of frame indicates the start of a new frame in the network. Standard data frame defined under CAN specification 2.0A contains 11-bit message identifier, which is used for arbitration. RTR bit defines the frame type, whether the frame is data frame or a remote frame. I will talk more about arbitration and frame types in the next video after we discuss about transmission of dominant and recessive bit. IDE bit in the control field stands for identifier extension. A dominant IDE bit indicates the 11-bit standard frame identifier, and a recessive IDE bit indicates 29-bit extended frame identifier. Then in the control field, we have data length code bits, which define the length of the data in the data field. In data field, maximum we can have up to 8 bytes. 4 bits are available in DLC to configure a number of bytes required in a particular message frame. The frame also contains 15-bit cyclic redundancy check or CRC field, which is used to detect any data corruption during transmission. The sender will compute the CRC before sending the frame. After receiving the frame, each receiver will compute the CRC again and compare with this. If the CRC doesn't match, the receiver will generate the error frame. Then comes the acknowledgement bit. One of the very interesting features of CAN protocol is how it handles acknowledgement. In most of the communication protocol, a separate acknowledgement frame is sent by the receiver after receiving all the bytes from sender. In CAN, there is no separate packet is sent. We will talk more about the acknowledgement mechanism in upcoming videos. At last, frame ends with 7 consecutive recessive bits called end of frame bits. So friends, here we come to end of this video. As this was the first time we were looking at the CAN frame, I try to make it as simple as possible. We will stay with this topic in the upcoming videos also and try to make it more clear. Let me know your feedback, and for all upcoming updates, don't forget to subscribe my channel techvedas.learn. Thanks for watching. Hope you like it.